Hi, it's me, Molly, little girl. We're up doing vests. I had to do a vest treatment because I was just coughing too much. And I had fallen asleep early last night on the couch and didn't get to do my last vest, so my body must have realized it because I woke up and coughing, and I tried to go to bed. I just couldn't get comfortable, and I just all of a sudden everything, I started coughing and everything started junking up. So I came down and did my vest and some of my inhaler medicines, and so I'm a little more comfortable right now. I'm a week into antibiotic therapy. I'm on 2 oral antibiotics and 1 inhaled antibiotic, and they don't do so well on my bugs. But it's a step that I need to take before they think about putting me back in the hospital. It would absolutely devastate me to go in right now because I have my Great Strides Walk, and I'm really excited about that. I worked really hard. Ken and I worked really, really hard to raise money, and we've already raised like $1,700, which is so much money. And to not be able to do that would be really stressful. I mean, even if I can't do the whole walk, I just want to be able to be there and support the people that joined our team and the people that gave. And I just need to be there. For the past few years, I've been going into the hospital every 5 to 6 months for IV antibiotics because my bugs are resistant. They're very strong. And I'm at the 6 month mark right now, just passed it like a week ago since I got out of the hospital the last time in November. And I'm just really nervous, you know, thinking, what am I doing differently since then? What can I do differently since then to try to, you know, make it longer? I want to make it a year without IVs, but that's probably not realistic. So I just have to do my best. You know, unfortunately, you know, I've been working really hard, my mind, trying to get my mind in the right place to do what I need to do. And I'm doing everything I need to do to keep my body doing its thing and keep my lungs as healthy and open and everything as possible, trying to exercise. But it's just scary. So I just want to make it through the summer. You know, Ken put a pool in for me 2 summers ago because it's really hard for me to get outside in the summer and be active because it's too hot. And I sweat a lot, and I lose a lot of salt through sweat and just a lot on my body. So having a pool, and it's just an above ground pool. It's not that big, but it's perfect. It allows me to not only go outside and get some of that wonderful vitamin D and the warmth of the sun, but it helps me. I do exercises in the pool. I had downloaded a United States Army water exercise sheet, and so, you know, whenever I go in the pool, which, you know, in the summer, it's just about every day. I start out, you know, I march around the perimeter of the pool, breathing deeply, and, you know, I'll do like 10 rounds in each direction. And then I'll do like high marches, like high walking. And the water supports you, and it's easier on my joints, and especially my knees, because I have a bad knee. So, you know, and then I'll do arm exercises and just all sorts of things. And it's very therapeutic. And then, you know, once I do all that, then I just float around and, you know, I have my noodles and just bounce around the pool. And, you know, I'm not really a swimmer. And, you know, the water's only like, what comes up to like here, but it's perfect. And it gives me a chance to exercise, a chance to be outside and not cooped up in the house all the time. And, you know, hopefully I can, you know, invite friends over to come hang out with me and, you know, play hooky and spend the day and, you know, my nieces and nephews. And so, yeah, so that's what I want my summer to be like. And that's why I'm scared to go in to the hospital anytime between now and the end of August. I know it's bratty, but I want my summer, you know. And getting a PICC line and having it in the summer would be like torture for me, because I have aversion to anything stuck to me. And the PICC line, I sweat, it's uncomfortable, and you can technically go in the water if you get like this, there's like this crazy rubber thing you can put around it, but you can't get it wet. So it's like, you know, I'd be too worried about destroying my PICC line by submerging it. So anyway, if you pray, I'm just asking you to pray that I do everything that I can, that I have the courage and strength to do everything I can, and that it's meant for my meds. It's meant for me to be able to get through the summer. I know it's really all in God's hands, or some people put it as fate or destiny or karma, but I just want to get through this summer before I need IVs again. And I want to have a healthy summer. You know, I don't want to be on in anyway. Just, that's all I ask. So I know it's like 4 o'clock in the morning, and, you know, fortunately I have a lot of time to think as I'm, you know, waiting for my meds to actually help me. So, I'm excited for Great Strides. Thank you to everybody who has donated, who has shared the link, and who have joined our team. Also, thank you for everyone who's purchased a t-shirt. That's also awareness. And just thank you. Thank you for the support. I could not do it without everybody. And I wouldn't want to do it without everybody. So I love you guys, and I hope that you all have a great day, and just pray, cross your fingers, send a positive vibes. I really want this weekend to be a great day for me and my family and my husband and everybody who had faith enough in me and faith enough that eventually we'll find a cure and better treatments. You know, who believed and that their donation or their awareness or their time will contribute to that. So I love you. I'm going to keep cuddling my kitty, and I'll see you later. Bye. Have a good night or morning.